you with us, folks. The brightest stars in Blackpool are all out to be seen this season, and we've got one for you right here tonight. It's Johnnie Casson. We've got him here for you. So, here's Johnny.
Hey. Thank you. Thank you. What a joy. I've actually come all the way from Yorkshire tonight, so that'll give you some idea how popular I'm up there. And, could you imagine, this fella's been in the pub all night and he's walking home through the streets of Soho, and this lady of the night jumps out of her doorway and she accosts this man on the pavement and she propositions him. He said, "I'm skint, I've been in the pub all night." She said, "Well, how much have you got left?" He went, "I've got a £5 note and that's it." She said, "Oh, that'll do, love, I'll give you a penguin for that." He said, "What's a penguin?" She said, "I'll show you." And she undid his pants like that and pulled them down to his ankles. She stood up again, pulled his underpants down to his ankles, stood up again. She grabbed the £5 note and ran off down the street. And this fella went, "Hey, bloody come back." What lovely people. You see, my problem was, you know, ladies and giblets, my big problem was that I didn't pay enough attention when I was at school, because when I went to school, you didn't appreciate the finer things of school life, you know, like being spanked by a middle-aged woman, you know. Things that you pay good money for nowadays, you know. Well, we're thick at school, though. I had to have a hole in my pocket so I could count to seven, and do you know, it's my mother's fault, I'll be honest with you, because every time I took a girl, oh, my mother didn't like her. She never liked one girl I took in the house. So I was in the pub one night and I saw this girl who looked just like my mother, only younger. So I took her home and my dad didn't like her. So what's the difference between in-laws and outlaws, eh? Outlaws are wanted. Open them gates, I'll be up in a minute. And, so this fella's listening to his little boy saying his prayers one night and he goes, "God bless mummy, God bless daddy, God bless grandma and goodbye granddad." And the old man pegs it in the night, and he thought nothing more of it till a fortnight later. He's listening again, the little lad says, "God bless mummy, God bless daddy, and bye-bye grandma." Oh, and the poor old lady gets knocked over the following day. Well, the fella's getting a bit edgy now. A week later, he hears the kid saying, "God bless mummy, and goodbye daddy." Well, he's in a right panic. Next day, he walks to work, he don't have anything to eat. He comes home at night very carefully, goes in the house and he sits down and says, "Oh my goodness, what a day I've had, I can't believe it." And his wife said, "Don't tell me about your day. I opened the door this morning and the milkman were dead on the steps." Now, you know, I was talking to my wife, I was listening to my wife the other week, and she says I'm nosy, right? It's nosy. She says, well, she hadn't actually told me that, but I read it in a diary. And I don't mind being married, but the hours are too long. And I shall never forget our wedding night. She was very nervous on the wedding night, my wife. She said, "I've never done this with a man before." I said, "Well, this is where we differ." I said. Before she goes to bed, she puts this stuff on her face every night. Oil of ugly. And, it's something like, it's working anyway, whatever they call it. And, anyway, she'd finished with that and she was just wiping her moustache out with Domestos. And I was pleasant with her. I said to her, "Raquel," I said, "what would you really, really like for your birthday?" She said, "Widow's pension, please." Do you know, I think she'd divorce me if she could find a way of doing it without making me happy. And I think she's lost respect, ladies, honest. She calls me thick in front of all her friends. She says, "He's thick, I wouldn't speak to him." Well, I've stuck it for months because I'm Taurus and quite slow to burn, you know. And anyway, they were all sat in the house last week and she called me thick and I flipped. I said, "Right, thick." And I stood up like that and I put my Etch-a-Sketch down like that. And I said to her, "Me, thick." I said, "She went to Benidorm for a week's holiday and she took 50 condoms and she hasn't even got a willy."